After seeing hundreds of Shopify stores, only a few are leveraging the Shop app. In this video, I want to show you how to boost your Shopify conversions with Shop app for free. Also, you don't want to miss the end because I will be going over how to precisely set up Shop app. All right, so let's kick things off by introducing you the Shop app. This is the ultimate shopping companion that brings together a world of a lot of different Shopify stores right here in your fingertips. Now, with this app, shoppers like myself can actually explore a wide range of products from a bunch of different Shopify stores, receive personalized recommendations, enjoy a seamless and convenient shopping experience. And essentially, like, if I were to summarize this, this is Amazon. This is a marketplace. This is the Amazon, but just exclusive for Shopify stores. And if you think about that, you would want to be on Amazon, right? A lot of people already shop on Amazon. A lot of people already have this app, this Shop app installed on their phones. And it's just a matter of enabling it to make sure that you're being shown on the Shop app. So as you can see here, we have shops that they think I may love just based off of things that I've shopped in the past and the different shops that I would love, different products that I may love. So it's a very good curated shopping experience for me. At the same time, I can actually follow the whole process, chat with the shop store owners and everything right here from this app. But from the customer's perspective, it's all about convenience, right? They can easily browse, add to cart, complete purchases without having to jump from one website to another. So I can buy pots and pans, I can buy something for my car, I can buy supplements, I can buy clothing, all within the same app just by just tapping a couple things and searching what I need to search. Now, what are the benefits for you as store owner? And this is actually the exciting part because for store owners, it can actually boost your conversions and it can make you more visible. And that would be my benefit number one. It just increased visibility, right? So by being part of the Shopify Shop app, your products can be discovered by millions of potential customers actively looking and using the Shop app. I mean, I can't tell you how many brands I've actually discovered by just using this app. Benefit number two, I will say, is also personalization. So the app actually leverages data to provide personalized product recommendations, increasing the chances of customers finding products they love. This is something that I truly love because let's say I shop from Ballers Court, I would get recommended products by big basketball t-shirts. I don't know, I'm just making stuff up, but you get the idea, right? So based off of how other customers shop, based off of the things that you have shopped for, based off of the things that you've added to cart or the things that you're clicking within the app, the algorithm can actually recommend you more personalized products and not just like willy-nilly every single store out there. And the good thing I like about it is that it recommends me actual products and it recommends me actual stores overall. It's like, hey, we think that you will love these stores right here. So as a discoverability tool, as a way for you to be in front of millions of eyeballs for free, it doesn't get any better than that. And I'll say benefit number three is the streamlined checkout. The app offers a hassle-free one-click checkout process, reducing cart abandonment rates, boosting your conversion rate. It obviously uses Shop Pay. The customer is already logged in to the app, so there's not a lot of information that they have to put in. It's just like click, 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 boom, done. And again, I keep comparing it to Amazon, but it's the same way, right? On Amazon, you're already logged into Amazon. Amazon already has all your cart information, all the shipping and everything. All you have to do is add to cart and then check out, and that's you're on your way out. Now, with anything that Shopify does and any of these additional things that they offer for store owners, there's gonna be some requirements, right? So this Shop app does have some requirements. Number one, you have to be in the starter plan or higher. You have to have Shopify payments enabled in the back end of your store. You have to have Shop Pay activated. You gotta make sure that you haven't had a chargeback rate of less than 1% in the last 6 months. And then obviously there's a couple of just, you know, flurries of things like just make sure that your store is not password protected or that it's not age restricted and things like that. We'll put the link down below on all the details for the requirements, but a lot of these things really is things that you already have enabled in the back end of your Shopify store. So really the last step, right, to have this enabled in your store is just to add it as a sales channel in the back end. So let's go ahead and do that. So here we have our test store. We can go to sales channels. We can type in Shop app. This will open up the app store. This is kind of like a merging thing that they've done with sales channels and apps not too long ago. So you'll see Shop channel right here. It's free and what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and install it. So after you install it, the first thing is going to be to set up your sort of storefront right within the app. So there's gonna be a few things that you can tweak right within here. And as you can see, we have our logo. Definitely want to upload your logo in here. Slogan or sort of a brand statement of who you are. Any background media right up here. Colors, and then it suggests some from our store right here. So at the very top, it's just gonna be almost like a little mini hero section for your store inside of the app. This is something that you cannot manipulate too much, but you definitely wanna make sure that you have these things in place. Okay, so I've added just a couple things in here just so you can kinda get an idea. And I just realized too that the color is default and you cannot change it if you add background media to it, which is not good, not a good experience overall so far. But I think if we get rid of this, see that now we can actually manipulate the color and it looks a little bit better. So just keep that in mind that when you add a background media, either video or image, you'll be very limited on whatever that color they basically decided for you. So you may be better off just selecting a color, updating your logo, a little brand slogan message in there, and just keeping it simple, but still keeping it on brand. Now, if you're interested in looking over the requirements, this next step will actually show you exactly what things you are already qualified for and what things you may still need to work on to fix within your store. So looks like right now for us, we need to, because it is a test store, we need to enable the Shopify payments. And then it looks like we have to make sure that we're not using any password or age verification apps in order to have this ready to go. So we're 5 out of 7 complete for this. Now, once you have everything figured out, the actual shop admin or dashboard will give you just a quick glimpse of how well really it's going to do for you. So you can see this particular store, they did in the last 30 days, they did $23,000 from the shop app, about 400 orders. This will give you a little preview of how your store looks, how many followers you have. So this particular store has 10,000 followers within the app, how many product impressions. So it gives you a little bit or enough data, right, to make sure that, you know, things are actually working and going in the right path. And then there's a few extra things that you can do. Obviously, if you have Shopify Inbox, which is the chat option of Shopify, it's all built in within the shop app as well. So if you have Shopify Inbox enabled, you can actually have that same chat back and forth experience right within the shop app. So the customers are able to just message you if they need to. You can also set up a post-purchase offer and you can set up shop cash offer. So the customers can get a little bit of money based off of purchases from your store, sort of like points, right? They're earning points or they're earning the shop cash from your store. So that's something, just a little bit of a marketing tactic that they have built in right within here. I can 100% see it in the very near future where they will probably allow you to run ads right here within this shop app store. So stay on top of that because that's gonna be a great opportunity for a lot of you. And then you also at the very end down here have shop minis. So think of these as just your regular apps that you're using on your store right now. There is a few of them that work right within the app as well. So as you can see, we have here size and fit. We have shoppable Instagram. So we video reviews, FAQs, shoppable videos, one-click upsell, which is one that we definitely recommend. You definitely have a few things in here that you can add as a shop mini to your store. So you can add some additional functionality and additional features for your customers. Now, another way that you can see a little bit more analytics from your store, you can actually go to your analytics, go to reports, go to sessions by refer under acquisition for the category. And then something that you can do here is you can manipulate the columns and you can add a UTM by campaign source. And then we can actually filter this campaign source again, and then just selecting shop app here at the very bottom and then apply filters. And this will actually just show us sales, or I guess this is just sessions by the shop app. So we've had 3 visitors in the past couple days to this particular store from the shop app. So this will give you a little bit more insight into this. And just an easy way for you to find, you know, the people that are coming from the shop app is to always add the UTM campaign source and add the shop.app as the source or the referrer right there. And you'll get that information right here within your Shopify store. All right, there you have it. That's all you need to know about the shop app right now. Now, if there's a couple things there that you may not qualify, or maybe you're in the process of getting it verified so you can actually be on the shop app, then the next best thing that you can do is check out this next video where we go over some of the bigger changes or things or tweaks that you can make to your store to make it more mobile friendly. That way, shop app is going to be the best mobile experience for your customers, but the second best is going to be directly on your website and you making sure to make the exact changes that you need to make in order to make it better for them. So check that out next.